Excitement in the kitchen. Say, let's see the excitement.
All right. Just you come along with me and I'll show it to you.
Hello, I'm Jonathan, otherwise known as Senor Smoke, here at Curto's in Westchester County, and I want to welcome you to something a bit different. I'm not broadcasting from the Curto showroom. I'm at Casa de Smoke here, as I sit here in front of my Kamado Joe, which is, we're roasting some chicken on there right now for dinner tonight, and I want to call this my first in a series of what we're going to call fireside chats, where I'm hanging out in front of whatever I'm smoking, and I'm just going to go improvise, stylize, and just bring it to you off the top of my head. And tonight's topic, my friend, for the first fireside chat is why the Aaron Franklin method of cooking brisket completely kicks ass and will minimize any potential chance you have to screw your brisket up. This past Friday, I made a brisket, brought it over to a family member's house for our annual summer smoke fest, and I can report to you that if you follow the Aaron Franklin brisket recipe, okay, which where the key part of that is wrapping your brisket in butcher paper, I can tell you that it is a near bulletproof, surefire way to nail ace your brisket. And we're talking brisket, which is the apex of barbecue, arguably the hardest thing to master when it comes to smoking. The brisket, simple to prepare, right? All you need, in my opinion, I'm gonna echo Aaron Franklin's sentiments as well, salt, pepper, that's really about it, and just good beef and smoke and you're good to go. No really esoteric rubs and brines and this and that. And trust me, I've read a lot of brisket recipes and Aaron is very straightforward, to the point, and the fact that he uses the butcher paper totally changes the game in my opinion. So what happened is I had a 12 pound full pack of brisket, probably a little more than 12 pounds. I figured 12 hours to cook, an hour for each pound. So the way I was gonna approach this, I was gonna go 12 hours, 10 hours in the smoker, and I was using my Memphis pellet grill, 225 degrees, 10 hours in the smoker. I was gonna remove it, wrap it in the butcher paper, and Aaron prefers the butcher paper because aluminum foil, the classic Texas crutch, tends to make things a little pot roasty, too stewy. So 10 hours on the cook, 2 hours wrapped in butcher paper in the smoker. So now we're 12 hours cooking the smoker. And then I was gonna take it out and let it sit wrapped in butcher paper for another 2 hours. So it would have been, what does that make? 14 hours before we served. So what happened is things as they are wont to do with brisket started to go sideways a little bit. I happened to just pop in the house. I put it on at 4 o'clock in the morning. I figured we had a 6 o'clock dinner time, 6:30, something like that. Put on at 4 in the morning. I came here about in the 10 hour, I think it was about 10 hours. Came here, checked it, the brisket was already measuring 205 degrees. I couldn't believe it. I started flipping. I was like, oh my God, I'm overcooking this. What am I gonna do? I have hours to go before this is served. So I quickly took it off the smoker, wrapped it in the butcher paper, and it was done at that point with the Memphis. Memphis was retired. Wrapped, put it in the cooler, and it sat in the cooler for at least 2 hours, if not longer. Because let's see, I went to his house for, basically it sat in the cooler for almost 4 hours. And what happened when I brought it over and I unwrapped it? I was nervous. I was getting ready to basically cut into shoe leather. Instead, what I couldn't cut into was one of the tastiest briskets I have ever made. So why did the cook start to go sideways? Why did it get the temperature so quickly? 10 hours, and I was cooking at 225. I believe the reason is twofold. Number one, it was an excruciatingly hot day last past Friday in New York, and the Memphis was in direct sunlight pretty much almost for the entire, not the entire cook, I put it on 4 in the morning, it was dark, but probably from about 8 o'clock on, it was pretty much in direct sunlight. I believe the heat definitely elevated the cook temperature inside the chamber. The other thing is, if you look at the Memphis, and I would actually ask other Memphis owners to please opine about this as well, There isn't a lot of headroom between the heat chamber on the Memphis and the actual grate, okay? You got your firebox down below, you have the indirect shield, and then there's the grate. There's really not a lot of room whatsoever between, it's inches, if that, between the plate and the grate, and then the firebox isn't that far below. I noticed that the bottom of the brisket was cooking much, much quicker than the top, so there was, it's close to it. Am I saying, I mean, every brisket I've made has been on a Memphis, and I've done a pretty good job with them. So I'm not by no means approaching this and trying to tell you that the Memphis may not be the correct vehicle to make a brisket. But the next time I make one, I am gonna try, I'm gonna do it on the Kamado, which is going to, it's going to create far more headroom between the fuel source, the heat, and where the brisket is laying, because I'm gonna put it on the topmost cooking grate, and we're gonna see if I have the same experience where the bottom is cooking much quicker than the top, or if we're going to get some type of convection process going on, which is gonna be more even. We'll see about that. But for something that so many people have written about and saying that brisket is so difficult to master, it's such a challenge, I appreciate that, there's no doubt about it. But I believe that employing the Franklin method, not that it idiot-proofs it, but it just makes it a lot easier. And I think if you just follow the rules, it's real simple. Whatever device you're on, it's 225, low and slow. Don't put a lot of stuff on your brisket. You don't need to rub marinade, this, that, injections. There's no need for it. Hit it with, I actually had a coating of olive oil. I don't know if, yes, I did. I put salt on it, pepper, a little bit of this coffee rub. We were done. I did not, also, very important, I did not let it sit in the refrigerator overnight. This is something I took from Meathead Goldwyn. I was gonna, the night before, like a day before, I was gonna basically let it brine in the refrigerator with the rub on. Meathead Goldwyn is not a proponent of that. So I literally put the rub on right before I put it onto the smoker. And like I said, it came out phenomenally well. So for your next brisket, I advise, invest in butcher paper. It makes all the difference in the world. You retain that moisture, things don't get mushy. Aaron Franklin is definitely a sage when it comes to beef. So heed the words, heed the advice. That's all I gotta say today. I'm gonna go have a beer and go check on my chicken over here. Hamburgers to follow, much more to come. This is a Fireside Chat with Senor Smoke. Thank you.